looking at our arcs combined now with our chords, we will see that two arcs, if congruent, if and only if the corresponding chords are also congruent. If a polygon is inscribed, it means that all the vertices lie on the same circle. A circle that is circumscribed contains all the vertices of that polygon. If a diameter or radius in a circle is perpendicular to a chord, then it will bisect the chord and the arc. If two chords are congruent, that means they must be both the same distance from the center point in the circle. Find the measure of the arc of this inscribed hexagon about the circumscribed circle. We must recognize again that all arcs are congruent to their central angles. We can create a central angle with the radii that intersects both the vertices of the hexagon, since it is inscribed, at the same time while still hitting the circle. Since this hexagon is divided into six pieces, that must mean that this central angle is 60 degrees. Which means that the arc must also be 60 degrees, since every arc is the same measurement as their central angle. Now in this circle, chord AB is 30, chord CD is also 30. And the arc from C to D, C to Z, measures 40. Since the radii are perpendicular to the chords, that means it bisects these chords. Which means that both segments will be the same since they are being bisected. Same reason, if you look at chord MD, it is also being bisected by the perpendicular radii, which means it also will measure 15. Again, since it is a perpendicular radii to that chord, it not only bisects the chord, but it also bisects the arc, which means that both pieces of the arc will measure 40. Which means the measurement of arc C to D is both 40 or 80 degrees. Since the chords are congruent, that means their arcs will be congruent. Therefore, that means all pieces of the arcs will also be congruent, which means the measurement of Y to B is also going to be 40 degrees. Now, in this picture, we are told the radius is 5. Segment P to Q is a radius. We're also told that PR is 3. To find segment PS, we must recognize that this is also a radius. So it too will be 5. Similarly, segment P to T is also another radius. So it too will be 5. Now to find the segment RS, although the radii is perpendicular and bisects the chord, we do not have anything about the chord. We do, however, have a right triangle, which means we can use the Pythagorean theorem to find the missing leg. In doing the Pythagorean theorem, we will see that the missing leg, which is the segment RS, is 4. Now again, since the chord is bisected, that means the other side is also 4, which now tells us that the entire segment QS is 8.